when I found out that I had breast cancer, and I did do the BRCA1 and the BRCA2 testing, and I was negative, but boy, my mother, who is a breast cancer survivor, she ran out and got the testing just because I have a sister, and she ran out, and everybody was negative. Plus, on my father's side, I have an aunt and a cousin who were also going through and are survivors of breast cancer. So it was kind of like this, you know, here are my sister and I getting the double whammy on both sides. And when all of that came to the forefront, I mean, it was, we broke down the family tree very quickly because I have a daughter and my sister has a daughter, and we did exactly what you and Dr. Harness have been saying all along, as far as, you know, let's get it out on paper. Let's see, you know, what's ahead for all of us.
Did you have a genetic counselor helping you with this? Good. I mean, what you described is a very in-depth nuance, and there's so many bizarre things that can happen. For instance, the case you mentioned, let's say you tested negative and you had breast cancer, it would have been a mistake to say, oh, your sister shouldn't worry about it, because we have had cases where the sister, young onset, had all the risk factors tested negative, and we end up testing the other sister, and lo and behold, she's positive. So, you know, you can actually get breast cancer on your own, or you might get it from the BRCA in the same family, and so that little nuance, knowing that, can literally save lives. And a professional, and thankfully you're guided by a professional, will tell you, no, don't stop there. I can't tell you how many tragedies are with these primary care physicians and gynecologists where they get these test kits shoved in front of their faces by the reps and saying, right, here, test them, and then they tell them it's negative. Jay, you have to agree with this. Sometimes it's a negative test that's more difficult to counsel than the positive. The positive in many ways leads to very clear choices. But when you're negative, what does that really mean? Is it a true negative? Should someone else be tested? Maybe you're missing BRCA. You know, we're talking today about breast ovaries, but breast and ovarian cancer is also part of Lynch syndrome. And it wouldn't be the first time that we've looked at a pedigree. Everybody's thinking BRCA and breast ovarian, and then you they're negative, and then you relook at it, and then it turns out to be Lynch. For ovarian cancer, 25% of ovarian cancers have a genetic cause, a hereditary genetic cause. Of that 25%, 75% of those are BRCA 1 and 2, but a quarter of those are a set of 15 other genes that are now testable, believe it or not. And so the world is opening up, the knowledge, the information. It is just bewildering that we're really honing down now and being able to pinpoint. But what, Lisa, you were describing is kind of like detective work, where you look at a pedigree and you've got to figure out what's going on here. Is it bad luck? Or is it a gene? I mean, we're power lines, if you believe in those. But my point is, get a professional. I can't say this enough. I think I've battled with some of the companies that market these genetic tests that they just pass out these test kits, and one of them sold at Walgreens. But it is so important to get proper counseling and testing to help you interpret the results, especially the negative results, because that's where tragedies can happen, is if you miss a negative and there's something else going on.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.